The midterm elections are on the horizon, and now that the U.S. has launched airstrikes against ISIS, one top Republican pollster tells CNN security is now a top-tier issue that no one saw coming. So how will the candidates campaign on the change? Here's one extreme example. In the New Mexico Senate race, Republican challenger Alan Way has been trailing badly in the polls behind the incumbent Democrat Tom Udall. So Way's now running an ad, not telling New Mexicans how he would vote on the battle against ISIS, but instead showing scary terrorists and burning buildings and, oh yes, a president who likes to golf. Here it is.
You give me this office, and in turn, my fears, doubts, insecurities, foibles, need for sleep, vacations, leisure, is gone.
Democratic Senator Tom Udall in Mexico.
I know, as far as I feel, this diplomatic path that we're on right now is a good one.
I am giving myself to you, and the American people should have no patience for whatever's going through your head, because you've got a job to do.
I know, as far as I feel, this diplomatic path that we're on right now is a good one.
He just got a freebie on us, right? Scott Brown, the New Hampshire Republican, challenging Senator Jeanne Shaheen, the Democrat, is running an ad claiming the terrorists threatening to cause the collapse of our country. In the midst of that hyperbole, Brown also fails to tell voters how he would vote to stop them. I want to bring in Marc Lamont Hill, CNN political commentator, and Tara Setmayer, co-host of Real News on The Blaze TV and a Republican strategist. Tara, will voters vote on this issue, or will it still be the economy stupid?
Well, interestingly enough, this is mirroring what happened in 2002. The Atlantic just did a piece not too long ago showing the parallels between 2002, when security moms were an important part of that election, and after 9/11. And not saying that there's anything that at the level of 9/11, but it's showing that polling, Wall Street Journal, showed that in August, 14% of women favored Obama's foreign policy. Now it's shrunken to 2. You know, women now are they're doing polling, focus grouping in Iowa. It's an important place where they show that that security issues are now replacing the economy. And don't tell me that Democrats aren't paying attention to that. They are. And Republicans are, too. That ad that we just saw in New Mexico, that's a pretty powerful ad. The perception of however you feel what Obama's doing, whether you think that it's the right thing or not to bomb Syria and Iraq, the perception is that Republicans are stronger on national security and Democrats are doves.
But does that hold water, Mark, where this president is launching airstrikes against the Islamic State? I mean, you can't kick sand in his face,
well,
can you?
That's exactly the problem, and I agree. Everyone's looking at security issues right now. It's a big campaign issue to the extent that people need to say something about it. But the problem is there's no clear war hawk, war dove here. The president has waged strikes. Republicans have uniformly said the last week, we like what the president is doing with regard to the scope and nature of the strikes. So it's hard to get mad at the president for that. And there are people who oppose arming rebels in Syria. There are people who oppose arming Kurds in the north. But the problem is it's not along partisan lines. There are people on the right who are saying, wait a minute, you know, we don't know who the moderates are. People on the left are saying the same thing. So it's tough to make this a partisan issue.
But the reason why it's partisan is because of what I just said. Perception. Over time, you know, people, they associate tougher security with Republicans, and that Democrats, because the president has dithered about for so long, the strikes are way overdue. Most people are talking about, especially in the military, that this is not enough. So the idea of a terrorist attack here happening in the United States, the idea that we're not safe, that perception is now burning into people's
minds. What about the Republicans
minds.
Who say we shouldn't intervene? Would they still be considered tough on terrorism?
I think, well, the fact that the Republicans, that we shouldn't intervene in Syria or Iraq?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. They're saying that we shouldn't intervene. I think what they're saying is
some
that we
are.
Need to have. Well, yeah, but those,
some are saying we shouldn't intervene.
But that's not the over. That's not the
here's,
overall
here's
overarching issue
about
here.
Which I know you're going to agree. Eric Holder is moving on. What's
yes.
his legacy, Tara?
His legacy is one of being a sycophant for the president, one who has made a disgrace of the office of attorney general, over-politicized it. He proudly claims himself as an activist. He didn't investigate Fast and Furious. He's been held in contempt of Congress, Benghazi, the IRS. Race and a race agitator. I say good riddance to Eric Holder. Thank God.
Do you need the floor?
We were doing
agree?
So well for the last few minutes. I mean, I think Eric Holder's legacy is one of an unprecedented role for the Attorney General. I think we're saying the same thing to that extent. You're saying he's doing things that other...
unprecedented in a bad way.
We just disagree whether it's good or bad or not. When you look at him going down to Ferguson, for example, that's unprecedented for sitting Attorney General. I think it's a great thing to do, to say, look, we're going to try to create justice. We're not going to choose sides yet, but we are going to look for justice here. Making a priority about not deporting particular people over others. Cracking down on major multinational corporations. Cracking down on corporate greed. These are big deals. These are good things. Again, is he a sycophant for the president? Is he politicizing the office? I haven't met an attorney general yet that isn't a sycophant for the president.
Deciding not to go after illegal aliens, you know, that's not a good thing. Trying to prosecute terrorists as criminals in the United States, that wasn't a good thing.
Due process for everybody? Oh, shut up.
Not for terrorists. That's what Guantanamo was for.
Tara Setmayer, thank you both so much.